Now, Mr. McKay, you have a, yes, sir.
I'm sorry, this discussion about victims, I don't know where the court said there's six victims. I've watched all the videos here, I've seen all the evidence, I don't know of six victims.
Well, the reason I said six victims is certainly only two girls were depicted on the video, but there was an apartment housing six, and I'm assuming all six of them felt like the privacy had been violated, that's all I know about that.
Okay, one girl undressed for 10 seconds does not make six victims. I've seen the video. One girl in a state of undress for 10 seconds, that's all.
There's another girl that was depicted, I didn't want to talk about this, but there's another girl depicted going to the bathroom, wasn't there?
No nudity, from the belly button up.
You don't think she felt violated by that?
Is that a victim?
How I define victim, yes.
Someone can watch me walk into a bathroom from the belly button up, and there's not going to be, I'm not going to be a victim. So, we got to call this what it is, too.
Well, I agree with you that there were only two girls depicted on the video, either in nudity or going to the bathroom. I agree with you there. I just said six because there were six people in the apartment, and I'm sure all six of them felt violated to know that there was a camera. Even if they weren't caught naked, I'm sure they felt violated by it.
Well, they certainly weren't recorded.
Okay, and I agree with you. And so I don't think there's any dispute as to the facts there. Anything you want to add to that, Mr. Wood?
No, Your Honor, that statement of facts is correct, but it's one thing to walk into a public bathroom and have people see you in there. It's quite another to know that someone's placed a camera in a place where you expect extreme privacy. And I think that makes each of those girls